as my brother just told me, he wouldn't want to come up here after that, so. But that's what it's all about, and it's truly a privilege to be honored by the Tourette Association of America. Julie and I are completely overwhelmed by the incredible support that you, our friends, our business colleagues have given us in our fight to defeat Tourette syndrome. You might think that the most difficult part of the evening is putting an event together like this is organization and preparation, but of course, Julie was in charge of that. So she did a great job with the dinner committee. Thank you. And she might have even been a little biased in her choice of honoree as the chair. Might have to recount those votes, a little Russian influence in the voting probably. There'll be a full investigation. The most difficult thing about an event like this, though, really, is to find the words with which to thank our friends for all they do. Really, to help solve a problem that most had never been familiar with before we were personally affected. Think about it. Tonight, in this room, our friends, our family, clients, partners, and even some competitors who try to beat my brains out every other day of the week, put it all aside and came together today to attack the terrible disorder Tourette syndrome. Tonight we'll raise just about $3,400,000. Thank you. That'll go to genetic research, outreach programs, and most importantly, to send a message to all the families all around the world that you heard today that help is on the way and that we will do better for them. It was a little over 20 years ago, while I was coaching my son's first grade basketball team, this is always tough for me, that I noticed he seemed to be punching himself in the stomach during the game. And at first I thought, those damn showboating LA Lakers with the chest pounding, and my son was imitating them. And I, of course, was a Knicks fan at the time, so that was doubly bad. But we quickly realized that it was not just his chest, and it didn't stop after the game. And soon, there were other fairly severe involuntary body motions, and Julie and I watched in disbelief as our son literally seemed to lose control over his body. And we felt equally powerless. You know, how could you make this stop? Everything else in the world seemed to be something we could affect. There was nothing we could do. And I'll never forget the day my son and I, we were lying on the couch, we were watching some sports game, he was probably about 8. And when you sat there on the couch together, you'd try to pretend that you didn't see or feel a major tick. And I think when he was relaxed, he'd tick even harder. And he turned to me and he asked me, "Daddy, can you make this go away?" It's one of those simple moments only a child could ask. But I'd say those words changed my life and my goals in my life forever. I made a promise to myself and my son that day, and I intend to fulfill it. It was about that time, after visiting dozens of specialists in several cities, that we found out it was Tourette syndrome. Julie, I have to give her credit, and my mom too, let me know that given the faith they have in me, they were sure if I could just take a year or two off from work, I could surely find the cure for Tourette, and then go back to being an investment banker, maybe even do it in my spare time. Well, I only wish the real world was as simple as Julie's world. Unfortunately, it's not. My partners that are all here tonight, thank you so much. They're probably astonished to hear me admit this, but I am not smart enough to cure Tourette. Although hopefully some of the brilliant doctors who are here with us tonight can. It shouldn't shock you that no single person can tackle this disorder on their own, and it should be even less shocking that I'm nowhere near creative to throw a big extravaganza entertainment dinner for you tonight. However, there is one thing I am certain of. No one will work longer hours with more fervor, more focus, and more tenacity to make sure all the money you contributed is going to the front lines to battle Tourette's. That's my promise to you. And even better, Julie joined the board of the Tourette Association of America, and those of you know her, she just might be smart enough to cure Tourette. And especially now that she's an empty nester, she's got a lot of time to do it. Lastly, there is one element of Julie's world that has come true for both of us. And that is we do live in a community surrounded by a group of unbelievable friends that have supported us for 20 years in ways that I think only seem to happen these days in episodes of This Is Us. You have to watch. Together, it's only a matter of time before we make the dreams of hundreds of thousands of children and adults come true and defeat Tourette's. And I think it's only fitting that Tourette syndrome, which attacks its victims by causing their own bodies to betray them with uncontrollable tics, erratic behavior, embarrassing vocal outbursts, will ultimately be defeated by the loyal, predictable, and steady actions of friends like you. Julie and I cannot thank you enough. Thank you for everything you did tonight.